द लैटिट्यूड एंड लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंशन ऑफ इंडिया इज 8 degrees 4 inches नॉर्थ एंड 37 degrees 6 inches ऑफ नॉर्थ लैटिट्यूड एंड 68 degrees 7 inches ईस्ट एंड 97 degrees 25 ईस्ट लॉन्गिट्यूड. इन बिटवीन दीज लैटिट्यूड्स एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड्स इंडिया इज लोकेटेड. यस
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am. Ma'am, here in law, in course book, here in longitude also they given both east only, no, ma'am.
Yeah,
they did not given about east.
Yeah, because why it is only east longitude is given because India is located in the northern hemisphere towards the east direction. So whatever all the latitudes are there, so the, sorry, whatever the longitudes are there, those all longitudes will be called as the east longitudes only. Right, and if you observe the latitudes also, both the latitudes are given as the north latitude because India is located in the northern hemisphere, right? So whatever the latitudes are there, so those latitudes will be called as the north latitudes only. Clear?
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So. So, and north to south, the extension of India is 3,214 kilometers, and east to west is 2,933 kilometers, and the main coastal, the mainland coastal line area is 6,100 kilometers, and the total coastal line area is 7,516 kilometers of coastal line we have in our country. And northmost point means which is the northmost point, the top north point of place is called as the Sichuan Glacier near the Karakoram Pass. So the Sichuan Glacier is the place which is the first place in the India in the northern direction, and in the last point in India is Indira Point, which is located in the South India. Okay, and the highest altitude is means the highest place in India is Mount K2, which is located in the Himalayas. The Mount K2 also will be called as the Mount Godwin Augustine. Okay, so this is the mountain which is located in the Himalaya. So this is the highest altitude place in our country, and the lowest altitude place is Kuttanand. Kuttanand is a place which is located in the Kerala, very low area, which is not very high place. It is very low area which is located in the Kerala. And the neighboring countries already we have discussed: Afghanistan, Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, China, Myanmar, and Maldives. So these are the neighboring countries which are surrounded by India. So these are some of the facts about India. Okay, and recently, children, the Jammu and Kashmir, all we know that Jammu and Kashmir is the, you know, the place which are divided into the union territories. Earlier it was a state. Jammu and Kashmir was a state where we used to have 29 states and 7 union territories in our country. But when the, you know, Jammu and Kashmir was divided into union territories, so now we have 28 states and 9 union territories in our country. So here in this map also you can see that the Jammu and Kashmir has been divided into 2 union territories.
Ma'am, can't see screen.
Now?
No, I can see.
Yeah. So Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So these are the 2 union territories we have. Earlier, Jammu and Kashmir was a state. Okay, due to its you know, the protection policies due to its neighboring, you know, the border issue and all with Pakistan, now it has been divided as the Union Territory on 31st October 2019. Okay, in 2019, on 31st October, the Jammu and Kashmir was divided into two Union Territories. So now we have 28 states and 8 Union Territories in our country.
Nine we have, ma'am, that time?
Yeah, that time we have 28 states and 29 states and 7 Union Territories. But now we have 28 states and 9 Union Territories. Okay, and India is the 7th largest country of the world. Just now we have discussed, and the boundary of India is 15,200 kilometers, and the total coastal line of the country, including the Andaman and Nicobar Island and Lakshadweep, is 7,516.6 kilometers. And bound by Young Fold Mountains, which recently the Himalayas are, you know, declared as the Young Fold Mountains. So which we have in the northwest and the north and the northeast part of India, where the Himalayas are located towards the northeast and the north direction. And the landmass tapers in the south and the extent towards the Indian Ocean and divided into two seas, the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. And India also will be called as the Peninsular India because three sides we have water: Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean and Arabian Sea. So where the land is covered with three sides of water, so that land will be called as the peninsular. Island means where, for example, if you take Andaman and Nicobar Islands, okay? So where these four sides of water is covered, so that place will be called as an island. But here, only three sides of water we have. So that is why India is called as a peninsular India. If it is, for example, if you take Andaman and Nicobar Islands, so where it is covered by four sides of water, so it is called an island. So India is located with three sides of water: Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean and Arabian Sea. So it is called as the Peninsular India. And the standard meridian of India that passed through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh, 82 degrees and 30 degrees east, is taken as the standard meridian of India. So children, all the times, like, we are calculating the time based on what we will calculate the time. So based on the longitudes and based on the longitudes, we will calculate the time. So the longitude which we calculate for our Indian time, the Indian standard time, is, which the longitude is 82 degrees and 30 degrees of east longitude, which is passing from the Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so this is the place, Uttar Pradesh, which is passing from the Uttar Pradesh, the Mirzapur, where the place is passing Mirzapur. So through this is the standard longitude line where we will calculate the time of India based on this Uttar Pradesh Mirzapur, the standard meridian or the standard longitude where we calculate the time. Okay, so this is the about the time and meridian which we will calculate for India. And the southernmost point of the Indian Union is Indira Point, got submerged under the sea water in 2004 during the tsunami. So just now I have told you the southernmost point of India means the end point of India in the south part, in the South India, that was Indira Point. So this Indira Point is submerged in the water due to the tsunami. Now we don't find the Indira Point in India map because it was disappeared due to its heavy floods, so in tsunami. So now we can't see that. So this is about the India and the location of India. Okay, and The neighboring countries in the northwest, our closest neighboring is Pakistan. So you can see here which is this north direction and this is west direction. So in between north and west, the country which is located in India is Pakistan, which is very closely located with the Indian neighboring border. So Pakistan is a country which is very closely located with India. And there are other countries in the northwest like Afghanistan and Iran also. So here you can see Afghanistan also, which is also located very close with the India, and Iran also one of the country which is located in the northwest direction of India. And in the north, China is our neighbor separated from India by the mighty Himalayas. So we all know that. So China is a country. So here you can see the China is a country which is located beside the India, neighboring country of India, but India and China both are separated from the Himalayas, which is located in the north direction. And other neighboring countries with whom India shares her land boundary in the north are Nepal and Bhutan. In the east is Bangladesh, while further east is Myanmar. So here you can see Bangladesh, okay, and Nepal, Bhutan. So these are the neighboring countries of India in the north direction. While India shares its boundary with all of its immediate neighbors, none of them have common borders with one another. In the south, our neighbors are the island countries of Sri Lanka and Maldives in the Indian Ocean. Okay, these are the islands. These islands also, they are located close to the India, Sri Lanka and Maldives. In the south, our neighbors are the island countries of Sri Lanka and Maldives in the Indian Ocean. Pakistan, India, Nepal, Bhutan, and Bangladesh together constitute a separate geographic unit known as the Indian subcontinent. Okay, Pakistan, Myanmar, Nepal, India, Bhutan. So these countries, Bangladesh, these countries together, earlier it used to be called as the Indian subcontinent. So here you should know what is mean by Indian subcontinent. That means it's not like a continent or it's not like a country. It's in the medium area. These all countries together occupied into the medium land area, not like a country, not like a continent. So these all countries together, earlier it used to be called as the Indian subcontinent, which means this landmass has all the geographic features of a continent, but this is not a continent, okay? These all countries together used to be called as the subcontinent, Indian subcontinent. Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, and Maldives have together formed a regional association known as South Asian Associations for Regional Cooperation, SAARC. We have discussed this one in your grade 5 when we were discussing about the UNO and its formation. At that time, we have discussed about the SAARC, committees also, where all, the South Asian countries of all the countries of the Asian continent have formed as the SAARC. SAARC means South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. So whatever the problems they get in the Asian continent with all the countries. So those, the solutions will be discussed in this SAARC meeting. So they will conduct every year, they will conduct the SAARC meetings, and whatever the problems will be there with the different countries of these Asian countries, so they will discuss in the SAARC meeting. So all the South Asian continents, they formed into the SAARC. So this is about the neighboring countries of the India. So okay, this topic is completed, and next topic we have is locational significance. India is located in the northern hemisphere. Is it that so important? You know, the place which is occupied by India, that means the location of India is helping the India for its development, or the location of India is useful for its development. So these all are the things which we will learn in this topic. So every, you know, the place of location plays an important role in the development of the country, or in the resources which we get, the natural resources also. If we have the natural resources more, so automatically the country will be developed more. So every place of location plays an important role in the development of the country. So likewise, India is located in the northern hemisphere as well. India has all types of the physical features in the country. That means we have mountains, we have desert, we have plains, we have plateaus, we have islands, even we have the coastal areas also. So how these all physical features are impacting on the development of the country, and how the location of the country is helping India to develop. So that topic we will learn, locational significance, how the location of India is important. So that topic let us see now. India is strategically located almost in the center of the earth, just 8 degrees north of the equator. So all we know that India is located in the center of the world. So let me show you the map. So children, here you can see the India is located in the center of the earth, right? So here there India is located, and here you can see, so this is the center of the earth, right? So India is located in the center of the earth, and just it is 8 degrees from the equator. That means, as equator already we have discussed that equator is a latitude which is dividing the earth into two equal halves. That means from equator to north pole and from equator to south pole, the distance will be almost same. That means equator is dividing the earth into two hemispheres. That means two equal halves. So here you have to understand that India is almost all located in the center of the earth, and the principal landmass of country is known as the mainland. Okay, so apart from the ocean areas, apart from the water areas, the land of India, which is called the land, will be called as the principal, mainland. So this is called as the mainland of India. Don't calculate the water bodies. So this India location is called as the mainland. If you look at the world map, you will find that the Indian mainland lies at the head of the Indian Ocean. So here you can see the Indian Ocean also, children. Can you see the Indian Ocean? So the Indian Ocean, which is located closely to the south part of India, and the base of the Indian Ocean is in the southern hemisphere. Its two other tips are located in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. Thus, India's location is of great significance, as it is almost in the center of the South Asia. The shape of the mainland is roughly triangular and lies below the Tropic of Cancer. So India, if you observe carefully, it looks like a, you know, triangular in shape. So here you can see as a triangular in shape. See, like this, okay, in a triangular shape. Mostly the South Indian part looks like a triangular shape, and where India has, okay, three water bodies, Indian Ocean, okay, Bay of Bengal, and the Arabian Sea. So this is the important location of the India. If you see, no other country is located like this, with the three oceans, Himalayas, desert, plains, plateaus, coastal areas, islands. So these all are the importance of the India. These all are the very, very, you know, the rare places of India, the rare physical features of the country. Nowhere in any other country you don't find all these kind of physical features in the world. Only these all types of physical features which are there in our country mostly. Right, if you see in the other countries, they may be there some plains, plateaus and mountains, or some of the countries are only located with the desert areas, or some countries are located with the mountain areas, or some countries are like islands and coastal areas, but none of the country is located with all the types of the physical features in the world. So this is a very, very important thing of the India. And advantages of the central location. Yes, if India is located in the central location, what are the advantages we have? Do we have any benefits that if India is located in the center part, do we have any benefits of it, or we have any demerits of it? So we have advantages because India is located at the central part of the earth. So we have the advantages due to that. The thing is that the central location of India is beneficially in the following ways. One is international trade. For India, it is very easy that it can trade with any of the country in the world because it is not located in the corner, it is not located at the top, or it is not located at the bottom. So for India, it is very easy to, you know, trade with any of the country in the world. So that is one thing where you know, the advantage of the central location of the India. And second thing is that civilization. The Indian subcontinent is the cradle of one of the four earliest Indian civilizations, the Indus Valley or the Harappan civilization. Today, this region is one of the most densely populated region in the world. So just now we have discussed that the civilizations which were started in India is Indus Valley civilization, which is a very, very important civilization. Like four civilizations which we have discussed earlier in the last class, that the you know, Nile civilization, Egyptian civilization, this Indus Valley civilization, like among all the you know, very famous civilization, India, the Indus civilization is also one of the important civilization which is, you know, which was located in India, where the people have been survived in our country. Now that place where the Indus Valley civilization was, you know, existed in our country, so that place now it is thickly populated area. So if you take Indus Valley civilization, so now it comes in between India and Pakistan countries. With these two countries, the Indus Valley civilization will be located. Most of the Indus Valley civilization will go into Pakistan region, and very less part will come into India. But whatever, the most important civilization which was started in India, because those days Pakistan was also included in India. So the Indus Valley civilization was also belongs to India those days. Okay, the famous civilization which was started in India. And the climate. Yes, climate is very, very important in India. So if you see, children, in South India, the climate will be different. In North India, the climate will be different. In near the Himalayas, the climate will be different. The Thar Desert, which is located in Rajasthan, there the climate is different. That means we don't have a stable climate in our country. Each part is differ with the, you know, climatical conditions. You all know that if Rajasthan, if you take, is it's a desert area, so the temperatures will be high.
If you take
Himalayas, due to this high altitude where the Himalayas are located, like on hills.
Very low.
Like those are very high places. So due to that, the Himalayas experiences minus degrees of temperature. Due to the Himalayas, the impact will be there in the other places of the North India, where the high hills are located in the North India. So that impact will be there in the other states of the country. So there also the temperatures will be not very cool like Himalayas, not very hot like Rajasthan or South India. They'll find the, or they will experience the medium temperatures in the North India. And when we talk about the temperatures of South India, okay, so children, now we have, you know, the temperatures are around 27, 28, you know, 30 degrees of temperatures in winter season in the North India. So that temperatures, here we have 30 degrees of temperatures in the winter season. So these temperatures we can see in the North India in the as the summer temperatures, like in the month of March and April, the temperatures will be like that. Means due to the Himalayas in the North India, the climate is different. And due to the equator, where the South India is located near to the equator region, so here the climate is different. So, and being at the head of the Indian Ocean, its climate is shaped by the winds blowing over the ocean called monsoon winds, which causes rainfall throughout the subcontinent. So as India is located in the near to the Indian Ocean, so where the winds will be blown from the Indian Ocean, so that causes the, you know, the monsoon winds. That means where the India receives the rainfall. So this is also one important, where the ocean, the winds which will be blown from the Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea, which, you know, leads to the monsoon rainfall in our country. And coming to the geographical unit, the Tropic of Cancer, 23 degrees 30 inches north, divide the Indian landmass into almost two equal halves, make the Indian subcontinent a distinct geographical unit. So as already I have told you, one of the latitude which is dividing India into two halves, that is Tropic of Cancer. Okay, Tropic of Cancer is the latitude which is dividing the India into two, you know, halves, that is North India and South India, right? So the latitude extension of the Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees, or 23.30 degrees of north latitude. So this is the latitude where it is dividing the India. The latitude name is Tropic of Cancer. Okay, Tropic of Cancer, the latitude which is dividing the India into two halves, that is North India and South India. Okay, clear? And India political division. So, as already I have told you that we have 28 states in our country, and 8-9 union territories in our country. As already I told you that Jammu and Kashmir is a, you know, the place, the state which has been divided into the union territory. So here you can see Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So these are the two union territories. Very recently in 2019, on October 31st, this state has been divided into the union territories. And children, you can observe here the different states and the union territories also here. If you take Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Orissa, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, okay, Bihar, and Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, and these all are the states which you can observe in this map. Okay, and here if you observe the children, the purple color line which is showing in the map, so that is the international boundary. That means the boundary between from one country to the other countries. And the white color line which you can see in the map, that is the state boundaries, means the state boundary between one state to the other states. And the red color mark, you can see the country capital. So here only you can see one red color mark, which is our country's capital city, Delhi. And the black color dot marks which you can see in the map, that indicates the state capital city. For example, if you take Odisha, Bhubaneswar, Andhra Pradesh, Amravati, Telangana, Hyderabad, and Tamil Nadu, Chennai. So likewise, you can see the capital cities and the states also. So this is the, you know, the political divisions of our country. So we have 28 states and 9 union territories in our country. 8 union territories. Right.